Hello, mages and sailors and gods, and welcome to the Inanimate Mr. Coatrack. Oh my gosh, it's so spooky! I love it! I love it!
Life. Death. Such incompatible conditions in the minds of modern science. The ancients had not seen it so. And as the blood star passes across our wretched sky, its vast crimson eye tearing the pool that sunders the plains, as I, Dr. Victor Bernhardt, raise challenge to our blasphemous obsession with mortality, those boundaries will once again be crossed.
Oh my gosh, this is so cool!
I must hasten now. Time's cruel auger twists on. The book. I should review what tasks remain me.
Oh my gosh. There's voice acting! There's voice acting! I wasn't expecting that! Oh my gosh, this is so cool!
I glance at the pages. The cruel, twisting runes that once felt otherworldly. So familiar now. Where your authors failed, I will succeed. Let's see. Yes. So close now. I have all I need. The mind. Yes. The soul. And the spark. Yes. Yes. Excellent. The elements are ready. Let us begin. Lest the blood star pass and forget this world for another millennia. My life's work, my beautiful creation, every organ, each vein, each shred of sinew meticulously reconstructed. Beautiful, but not yet complete. I must hurry.
Electric dynamo served to generate the current required. Okay, so let's do this.
Demon. Nerve, revive deadened synapse with thine power.
Okay.
I have no pressing use for my equipment. The brain must be introduced to the host. The life sacrifice.
Oh, okay. Oh, I see it. I see it. Oh my gosh, I love the music. Can we just talk about how cute?
The most grotesque of bodily organs, provenance of all the evils of man.
What
a donor organ so fresh should avail itself to my purposes this very day.
This is so cool. This game is so cool. And it was free. Oh my gosh, but the music. Let's listen to the music. How cool the music is. Oh my gosh. I love it!
I set the organ in the black ooze that pooled at the base of its skull, surrogate for the body's natural fluids. Though your body is not yet complete, my creation, it will suffice.
Dark clouds hung ominously over the university grounds. Ooh, it's so ominous. Okay, can I just, but like, seriously, I love how descriptive the character is, like, you know. Okay, what's the thing?
The life sacrifice must be in place for vital transference.
Oh, snake.
Come, Apophis, your fate awaits. Apophis, my companion, you have served dutifully. One last thing I ask you. Essence, in pursuit of perfection. Everything is set. I stand. of the greatest accomplishment of man. Let the procedure begin. Heart in throat as the cadaver stirs. Veins pulsing visibly through pallid skin. Pumping the black vitreous ooze that was my life's work. It's working. Rise! Rise! His gaze turns toward me. Gloomy yellow eyes oozing with the black tar. I've done it! At long last! Death recoiled from mortal form. The very boundaries of life and death unmade! I am the creator! I am God!
Ha! You boffins crack me up! Brought me back, have you? What fun!
Indeed. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Dr. Victor Bernhardt.
Good for you, Bernie.
Good for you. I prefer Dr.
Name's Coatrack. Argyle Coatrack. Good to know ya. Hey, I like this carcass you stuck me in. It's got a lot of pep.
Pep?
Yeah. Hey, how's about we go for a good old steak and kidney and some rumpy pumpy, eh?
Please, I know you must find this very confusing.
Nonsense! You scooped me noodle out me casket, stuck me in this here pile of parts. What science can't do nowadays, eh?
Quite.
Well, let's see how the world got on without Argyle Coatrack.
How do you feel?
Dandy!
No ill effects from the reanimation.
Nope, good as new.
Do you have any recollection of the other side?
Death? Well, I wasn't really paying attention. Wait, yes, there was a bright light. My whole life flashed before my eyes. What a riot that was! I remember Peter. Standing before the pearly gates.
Extraordinary.
Yeah, the gates is a nightclub downtown. Pete's a good friend of mine. Always lets me in.
Oh, I see. I must collect my thoughts before conversing further with the creature.
Call me Argyle.
I have no...
Okay.
In theory, it was simple. Suck the life essence from a dying vassal, convey it to the host. I contrived the device in 2 short months, though working the sulfurous mercury had taken years off my life.
Okay. What do I do? Okay. Oh, I can walk over here. Okay.
I've no care to read of the trivialities within.
Say, that the latest rag? Let's have a look.
The abomination licks its thumb with a black tongue and proceeds to flick through the pages.
Ha! There we are. Argyle Coatrack. Jeez, they really cheaped out on the obituary. Those fuckers! Until I waltz in there, flashing this new zombie body. That really ticked them off! To think they had me down as suicide! T'was murder, Bernie! Murder most foul!
Oh my.
Oh my gosh, wait. What?
This mob likely
sucked. Wait, no, I did!
Feeble attempt to pry open the lid. The infernal things nailed shut.
Okay, I want to talk to him.
I must collect my...
Call
okay.
me!
Okay.
I attempt to lift the heavy door, straining against the rotting oak. Alas, my weeks of solitude have taken a cruel toll. My palsied limbs have not the strength.
You should join my Zumba class!
The infernal... internal things nailed shut.
The crate had been delivered the week prior. I had no time to open it. Oh, what? I've long stopped recognizing the gaunt features that stared back.
I'd forsaken my youth in wretched study of these tomes. All worth it for the prize now before me.
Got any romance? I'd like a bit of filth in my literature.
I have no...
Okay.
Device conveys the vital essence from a living subject to a host.
So that's how Johnny Carson kept his youthful good looks all these years.
Oh my gosh. This is so cool.
I
don't even care that I'm kind of stuck right now.
My perfect creation. Will you lend me your strength?
Of course, Bernie.
Dr. Bernhardt.
And call me Argyle.
I don't see how my creation could be of use there.
Wait, what?
My undead companion would be of no use.
Bernie, give me a chance.
No need for the services of my creation here.
Oh, yes? Well, what if I... No, I guess you're right.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Okay.
I must collect my...
Call me!
The device can...
So that's how...
The device...
So that...
I must collect my...
Call me!
Alas, but...
You should join my Zoom...
how did I do that?
So that's a...
The device. I have my perfect creation.
Of course.
Okay.
I don't think I'm...
No, I wanna... Okay. How do I...
I must call. I must collect my
call.
Okay, I have no idea why. Okay. Oh.
I must call. I must call.
Oh. Oops. I forgot there was an inventory.
Corded muscle dribbles under decayed skin as my creation throws open the door.
Say, Bernie.
Bernhardt.
Not to complain, but with all this trapdoor opening, I couldn't help but notice. I seem to be missing an arm.
Yes, I had difficulties. Sourcing the final parts.
Wouldn't normally make a fuss, you know, but well.
Fear not, my ungodly creation. Together, we shall find you a hand. A dread claw with which to reach into the rotting minds of men and hold grip the very black and beating heart of reason.
Yes, good. I sometimes use that hand when the other one's busy.
Can you open this?
Some rotters nailed this shut.
Okay, yeah, I don't have any other tools, so let's go.
Don't see any severed arms lying around here.
Patience, Argyle. We shall find the parts you need.
Don't go plural on me, Bernie. What else am I missing?
Only the cardiac.
Never heard of him.
Your heart, Coatrack. The brain donor's heart, your original one, was, well, weak.
Weak ticker? Nonsense. I start every morning with a hearty full English.
Nevertheless, while most parts could be sourced from older specimens, you need a fresh heart before sunrise.
Well, there's got to be one around here somewhere.
Door led to the laboratory of Dr. Hawkbum? I have no idea. Head of zoology.
Dr. Koshbaum.
Koshbaum.
Zoology. They have a zoo here? Ooh, I want to see the giraffes.
She is no mere zookeeper, Argyle, but the leading biologist in her field.
Those noodle necks get me every time.
She is the most intelligent, beautiful woman to e'er grace the wretched earth.
Oh, Bernie, you got a thing for her?
Alas, she would not notice a pitiful wretch such as myself. But, my creation, all that will change once you are completed. When the world does tremble before my power over mortality, then, as I love her, so shall she be compelled by the very forces of nature to love me too.
I don't know, Bernie. Sounds a bit rapey to me.
What? No. I
maybe cool it with the compelled by nature angle. Just ask her out.
Okay, let's go in here.
Go on, ask her.
Good doctor. Oh, hello, Victor. I hope you don't think this rather forward, but... who's your handsome friend? this is...
Argyle Coatrack, enchanté.
Oh, I like this one.
And you, my vision of loveliness, must be Dr. Koshbaum.
It's pronounced Cockbottom, love. The pleasure's mine and all.
Cockbottom?
Cockbottom.
Cockbottom.
Cockbottom. Cockbottom. Cock.
Cock.
Bottom.
Cockbottom.
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 Bottom. Cockbottom.
Cockbottom.
I'm gonna end this episode here. I hope you enjoyed it. For now, I have to go, but until the next time, smooth sailing to you and your pirate crew.